Can millions of typical Americans, seemingly splintered politically in many ways, sometimes at each other's throats, join together in one movement? We believe, with a little goodwill by all sides, that it can be done, because there is actually more agreement among modern progressives and traditional and working class conservatives than either side has with the Democratic and Republican parties. Let us consider what both progressives and traditional conservatives have in common. Both modern progressives and traditional conservatives are frustrated with the political system, their government, and the politicians. And both modern progressives and traditional conservatives are effectively marginalized from any semblance of substantial political influence. The Democratic Party takes for granted that progressives, having nowhere else to go, will vote for the Democratic candidate. The Republican Party takes for granted that social conservatives, having nowhere else to go, will vote for the Republican candidate. As a result, both modern progressives and traditional conservatives have been abandoned by the two parties. Trying to squeeze concessions from the parties has a long history of futility, and as long as progressives and conservatives can be taken for granted, they will continue to have no meaningful political participation, and therefore no political leverage. That alone is sufficient reason for unification. Modern progressives and traditional conservatives cannot hope to bring about the populist structural changes each desire by working independently. To have any hope of achieving significant political gains, both modern progressives and traditional conservatives must join in a coalition with those who are falsely considered to be their political opposite. The resultant coalition would be a powerful base that would infectiously appeal to all strands in the population, most of whom are also dissatisfied with the political system and are eager to support a credible third choice. The American revolutionaries may have had many budding disagreements among themselves over political philosophy and the great political issues of their day, but it remained a moot point until they united to throw off the British yoke. In like manner, modern progressives and traditional conservatives should be eager to form a coalition that blends each side's priorities, because there can be no realistic hope of advancement for either the progressive or conservative agenda until both parties are handily defeated in a presidential election. Neither progressives nor conservatives are strong enough to challenge the system by themselves, and for the present, only fools fight among themselves in a burning house. But there is far more that modern progressives and traditional conservatives have in common than mutual hostility for the current political system in America. Both modern progressives and traditional conservatives are opposed to an aggressive foreign policy in pursuit of American empire. Progressives emphasize the detrimental effects on foreigners from the pursuit, while conservatives emphasize the detrimental effects on our republican form of government. But both are united in their opposition to America's pursuit of empire. Both modern progressives and traditional conservatives are opposed to globalization. Progressives emphasize the detrimental effects on American workers, while conservatives emphasize the detrimental effects to America's national sovereignty. But both are united in their opposition to globalization, outsourcing, and the idolatry of so-called free trade. Both modern progressives and traditional conservatives are opposed to uncontrolled illegal immigration. Progressives emphasize the detrimental effects on unskilled workers, while conservatives emphasize the detrimental effects on America's culture. But both are united in their opposition to uncontrolled borders. Both modern progressives and traditional conservatives deplore the societal trend toward ever larger centralization of political authority in unelected bureaucracies. Progressives emphasized the threat from corporate hierarchies, while the conservatives emphasized the threat from government bureaucracies. But both are united in their opposition to ever greater centralization of economic power and political authority. Both modern progressives and traditional conservatives are opposed to the neglect of the rampant crime pervasive in American society. Progressives emphasize corporate crime, fraud, and abuse, while conservatives emphasize individual street crime. But both are united in standing unflinchingly for a lawful society. Both modern progressives and traditional conservatives are sickened by the coarsening of society from commercialized culture. Progressives emphasize the commercial exploitation of violence for corporate profit, while the conservatives emphasize the commercial exploitation of sex for corporate profit. But both are united in opposing the blatant anti-family values of commercial culture for corporate profit. Both modern progressives and traditional conservatives are adamant about defending civil liberties. Howls against the Patriot Act were heard from both the left and the right. Both modern progressives and traditional conservatives are opposed to government subsidies to multinational corporations and industrial agriculture, along with bailouts to banks and other large politically connected lending institutions. Both modern progressives and traditional conservatives are uncomfortable with the Federal Reserve's absolute power over the American economy and its lack of accountability. That is a lot of commonality.